You've been waiting for it, I've been waiting for it, but what is it gonna pack? Let's talk about the Nokia 7.3 or 7.3, whichever works for you. Before we start, what I'm about to tell you is all based on speculation, rumors, and a bit of my guessing based on my experience with the brand. I could possibly be 100% wrong about everything I'm gonna tell you, although I personally doubt that. Anyways, let's get into it. So let's start with the design. Based on the very recent leaks on the Bond movie set, it's gonna look quite similar to the Nokia 5.3. So you can expect it to have a very similar look and feel to the Nokia 5.3, but with slightly better materials. I expect to see aluminum edges and a glass back. If you've seen the current 7.2, it should be somewhere between that and the 5.3. You can also expect it to carry very similar color options. So you'll get a very nice cyan green color, you'll also get the dark gray charcoal version, and a sand version. This is all purely speculation though. I wouldn't be surprised if they come out with a very nice shade of silver, for example. As for the front of the device, it's gonna carry a display that measures at around 6.5 inches. It's also safe to assume that it will have a 1080p display panel. Unfortunately, based on the display of the Nokia 8.3, which is a higher end model, you can also expect it to have an LCD display. Things are still not very clear about whether it's going to carry a notch or a punch hole, but I do expect a punch hole camera design. HMD CPO also hinted that it might have a higher refresh rate than 60 Hz. So I expect it between 90 and 120, with it most likely getting a 90 Hz display. It's also pretty safe to assume that it's gonna carry the Pure Display settings. So it will be able to transfer standard dynamic range content into high dynamic range content. As for the processor, and based on some of the cryptic tweets by the CPO again, you can also expect it to have 5G support, which narrows down the processor to two options, either the Snapdragon 765G or the Snapdragon 690G. That's assuming they go with Qualcomm. Because the 8.3 has the 765G, I don't expect the 7.3 to carry the same processor. So my best guess would be that it will have the Snapdragon 690G processor, which is a decent processor on its own. I would have loved for it to actually have the 765 as it would make it more competitive, but I just don't think so. As for the GPU, the one paired with the 690G is the Adreno 619. This is a capable GPU, so you'll most likely be able to play graphic intensive games on high settings. As for the RAM and storage, I expect it to carry 4 GB of RAM and a base storage size of 64 GB. You'll also most likely be able to extend that with an SD slot. What I wish they'd do is they'd actually put a faster storage option, such as UFS 3.0 at least. Let's see if that's the case. As for the cameras on its back, this is actually really tough to try and figure out. Are they gonna go for the same sensor as the 8.3, a 64 megapixel sensor? I honestly doubt it. It'll most likely carry a 48 megapixel sensor, basically an improved version of what the 7.2 currently has. It's also a pretty safe bet to assume that it's gonna have an 8 megapixel ultra-wide camera, as well as a depth sensor, and maybe a macro lens. And based on the camera settings on the 5.3, I also expect them to be focusing on night mode. So let's hope it's gonna turn out to be any good. Let's talk about the battery capacity. So the current model, the 7.2, has a 3500 milliamp battery, and I expect the new model to come with at least 4000 milliamps capacity. So yeah, if I had to take a wild guess, it's gonna be between 4000 and 4300 milliamps. I mean, that's pretty much a standard thing these days with mid-ranger devices, and that should last you about 1.5 days of use. As for the price, I expect the launch price to be somewhere around the $399 price range. What I'm actually hoping they do is that they'd release it closer to the $350 price range. That would make it very competitive. As for the software, there's pretty much no need to guess whatsoever. It's pretty much guaranteed to come with Android 1 version of Android 10. Android 1, 10? It's so confusing, but you get what I mean. The launcher will be stock Android, completely dependent on Google services. And you can expect certain things such as double tap to wake up and some advanced settings when it comes to display. But other than that, there will also be a custom camera app. And yeah, that's pretty much all their contribution when it comes to the software. Based on what they've been recently saying, they're more focused on trying to bring 5G to as many price points as possible. So this will be their cheapest 5G phone yet. If I had to guess when you'll expect to see these devices announced, it'll pretty much be in September. I just want to say one more time that these are all based on rumors, speculations, and my own experience. So as always, take all this stuff with a grain of salt, or a container of salt, or as much salt as you need. I'll probably do another video once it's announced to see how close or how far I was off based on predicting the specs. So you can look forward to that. So what do you guys think about what I mentioned when it comes to specs versus price? Do you think that's gonna be a competitive device? Let me know in the comments down below. Also mention anything that you wish to see in this device. I'm quite curious to know what you guys want. As always, thank you all very much for watching. If you've liked this video, please share, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.